It had been a slow old year. Me and Bugsy, that's my partner, see. And with nothing to do, we were catching 40, if you know what I mean. Confused, that's what they called me. The Asian detective with the English accent. Didn't let it bother me though. I was the best around, and they all knew it. Like I said, work had been slow, real slow. And for a private eye, that's no joke. If I ever wanted to eat a steak dinner again, I needed some real work. You know what they say though, be careful what you wish for. Perhaps I shouldn't have wished so hard and never have ended up in this mess. She burst through my door like a, well, I'm not quite sure what it was like, but it sure wasn't pleasant. And she sat there ranting about how her cookies had gone and got themselves stolen. Now if you were me, you'd think that she was a pretty far-fetched proposition too, and I told her so. Well, that set her right off, and she didn't help me in no way whatsoever. So, after pleading with me for hours, I civilly went into it, then she went into the details. Turns out a little baker here had been cooking up a storm. A real humdinger of a baking afternoon. Put her precious cookies on and then set them down to cool on a rack. Nothing suspicious there, says I says. Then she says that she was cleaning up and whatnot, and from out of nowhere some joker pops her clean over the head. Now, by the time she comes to, her cookies are gone, and the only memory she has is a nasty bump on the head to remember what went down. So I tell her not to worry, and I promise her that we'll look into it. We returned to the scene of the crime to look for clues. She'd sure taken a knock alright, and the cookies were most definitely gone. We returned back to the office, only to be interrupted by a call on the old telephone. Another robbery. This time some poor fella out on his own in the middle of no goodsville, going for a walk of all things. He took us through the particulars. As he recalled the details to me, I just couldn't help but start thinking that the two cases was linked somehow. Same MO, the poor joker never saw him coming. They just came up from behind and clocked him good, then run away with the goods. We looked into it, but that alley was bare as could be, nothing but junk and empty leads. I told him we'd do the best we could, but with nothing to go on, and the only thing between the cases similar being that these thieves had a taste of the sweet, I felt as stuck as a pig in mud who's been out in the sun too long and caught himself stuck there. We looked, we searched, but nothing seemed to come. I'd just about given up all hope when we had another breakthrough, an attack. I felt like Lindy hopping my way home. This time the attack was on some poor old bookworm. The dame just got herself sat down for a good read, reach for her favourite delectable booty, only to find herself short one jar of cookies. So she starts looking for them, when from nowhere, bang, she's hit from behind, and doesn't even know what happened. Well, that was the last straw. Me and Muggsy had to solve the case. We just had to. So we did what we did best. We detected. For days we looked and thought and thought and looked. But nothing seemed to come. A couple of false alarms later, we had nailed it and headed off to catch those no goods who'd been stealing up all the cookies in the place that they could get their greedy mitts onto. Turned out a gang of hardened criminals, whose nastiness knows no bounds, and set up shop in my fair city. But I figured we could handle them. I mean, all they steal is cookies, right? How dangerous could it be? How dangerous could it be? Famous last words, as they say. Anyway, we headed out to try and stop them. So we made our way over to the east side, to this hideout lair, if you like, of these criminals, and just burst down the door. I guess that was mistake number one. And mistake number two was probably not running away as quick as we could. And mistake number three was definitely getting tied up. So, if you find this, tell my mother I love her. And remember me as a good detective. I really was. I promise. I promise. I was terrible.